My name is Miriam. I'm not a professional organizer. I am a librarian, literally on my lunch break. Yeah!
At noon on Tuesday, from Towson to Washington, D.C. and beyond, demonstrators made some noise in a nationwide protest against strict new abortion bans in Alabama, Missouri, and other states.
And when we have abortion bans and these restrictions, they disproportionately affect poor women, they affect women of color, they affect black women.
They're eating away at Roe v. Wade, piece by piece by piece, till there'll be nothing left of it, and that's what we're afraid of.
We are tired of being oppressed.
At the Towson rally, just one side of the abortion issue was making its voice heard, but pro-life groups did stage counter-protests in other locations, like Hartford, Connecticut. All of this comes 1 week after Alabama passed the strictest abortion law in the country, making it illegal in nearly every case, even rape and incest. Supporters are betting on a court challenge, hoping the U.S. Supreme Court revisits Roe versus Wade.
Even in Maryland, we have adopted Roe v. Wade. We never know.
She's talking about Maryland's 1992 ballot resolution codifying Roe versus Wade in our state, stemming largely from a push by former state senator Paula Hollinger, a pro-choice leader in her time at the State House, a pro-choice activist today in Towson.
Women have to stand up. I have daughters, I have granddaughters. We can't go backwards.
In addition to War Memorial Plaza, other abortion rights protests that are getting ready to kick off right now are taking place in Annapolis, in Frederick, and in Silver Spring. Reporting live downtown tonight, I'm Kate Amara, WBAL-TV 11 News.